next guest, I love living in a small town. Our next guest, I always refer to him as RBW, you know, and every time I say, like, RBW's here. That stands for Robert Burke Warren. And the fun fact that he gave us for this evening is that he once got the hairy eyeball from Allen Ginsberg. RBW!
There are no photos, there are no flyers, even Google has no trace of a summer 1990 gig at Sideshows by the Seashore in Coney Island, a rare solo acoustic performance by Dee Dee Ramone. But I know it happened, because my band not only opened for Dee Dee, I chauffeured him and his teenage girlfriend to the show and back to Manhattan. I was 25 years old. Dee Dee was 39 and had recently quit the almighty Ramones, with whom he had changed the course of popular music. He was 13 years away from a fatal heroin overdose. "How would you like to open for Dee Dee Ramone for $50? The club owner asks. How could I resist? The exposure! And would you mind giving Dee Dee a ride? Dee Dee doesn't drive. I pick up Dee Dee and his tiny, beautiful goth girlfriend on East 9th. They share the same unnaturally black hair, their bodies all angles beneath snug black clothes. He holds a sad, battered guitar case. I call, "Hey, Dee Dee!" And he smiles a toothless smile, his face sunken. They tumble into the back seat, and almost immediately, Dee Dee says to the girl, "Listen, Cheryl, tonight is my night, okay? If you have any problems with that, we can just let you out here, okay?" She whispers, "Okay." On the drive to Brooklyn, Dee Dee enthuses about his new life, how he's finally learned to write a check and can finally take care of himself. He makes sure to tell us he'd written all the Ramones' best songs, which in fact is true. "Except Sedated," he says. "That's Joey's." Then he says to Cheryl, "Okay, I'm gonna take a little nap now." And he lays his head on her shoulder and does just that as she stares into space. Incredibly, the show is not well attended. Maybe 50 people, but Dee Dee doesn't care, and he's riveting. He performs all his Ramones tunes, just him and that crappy guitar, his voice lispy due to lack of teeth, but confident. Rockaway Beach, 53rd and 3rd, Blitzkrieg Bop. Then he introduces a new song. "This is about my dad," he says. "It's called Better Way to Live." The verses tell of a rascal father, a ne'er-do-well in a convertible who terrifies and fascinates his son. Dee Dee sings, "Daddy, all the time we wasted, we didn't know a better way to live. But deep in my heart, I knew you'd always be an easy man to forgive." It's lovely. But apparently, in the haze of drugs and mental illness that is Dee Dee's life, no one will ever think to record it. It seems to exist now only in my memory. On the drive back, Cheryl cradles Dee Dee in the back seat. I gush about how much I love the song. After a few moments, he shifts in the darkness and says, "Yeah, that's a hit. I write the hits, you know." Thanks.
Robert Burke Warren.